Welcome back to Stay Alive. Right, we are continuing our eye series, and as always, I have Dr. Kwame Bonsu in the studio with me, our optometrist. Hello, how are you?
Hello, Cecilia.
you're seeming very calm today. It's Friday, we should be jumping up on the chair.
Very soon,
right. Okay, so today we're talking about computer vision syndrome. I'm assuming, so when I saw this before, I assumed that, okay, it's got to do with a computer, right?
Yes.
Okay, and maybe staring at it as well.
Yeah.
Which is probably going to affect almost all of our sedentary workers who work, with computers. So if you are just hearing this, come and sit down and concentrate on what Dr. Bonsu has to say about computer syndrome. Right. My first question to you. What can you explain to us exactly what computer syndrome is?
So computer vision syndrome, or CVS for short, is a group of eye conditions or eye symptoms that comes as a result of prolonged computer use, looking at the screen for a long time.
Right.
So basically that is it. When we say a computer, it doesn't just limit ourselves to
Just computers at the, work.
Yeah, the right. Personal computers and our laptops and all. It's a wide range of things that come into our mind when we say computer. So computer vision syndrome. So it deals more with a monitor.
Right. Okay.
A screen.
So it could be anything from your phone.
Yes.
Right, to maybe the TV even. Yeah.
So your phone, your tablet.
Yeah.
Your computer screens, your laptop, anything that has a screen.
Right. Okay. And that's what it basically is. So what exactly is happening to the eye, and why does this affect the eye in such a negative way?
Oh, okay. So computer vision syndrome occurs, one, as a result of prolonged computer usage, being behind the screen for a long time. Okay. So things that bring about it or increase the risk at which you get computer vision syndrome include farsightedness, which you talked about some weeks ago,
right.
Hyperopia, presbyopia as well, and dry eyes as well.
Right.
Okay. So once you have these conditions, you are likely to get to experience the computer vision syndrome.
Right. So you were saying that, you know, prolonged time in front of the screens, but now what they're doing is they're doing 3D. They're making the screens come to you.
Yeah.
All of these TVs are now involving you and drawing you into the screen. Is this also going to be a problem in terms of causing computer vision syndrome?
Okay. So we've evolved. Okay. So we were once using the cathode red tube screens, locally known as Etikopo.
Today, dear, you've come out of a lot of stuff today.
And right. We moved through to LCD to LED.
Right.
So they are now limiting the radiation from the screens to the eye.
Right.
Especially the blue wavelength, the blue light wavelength.
Right.
They are reducing it so that it causes less harm to the eye.
Right. Okay. So even with that in mind, sitting in front of it, when we say sitting in front of, how long is too bad for the eye? Like, how long at a time do you have?
So we are more, a lot of people now in the corporate world where technology has taken over, where we are used to being on our phones, on our computers and all.
Yeah.
So sometimes you even get a group of friends sitting down and all of them are on their phone instead of communicating.
Yes, talking to other friends.
Yeah. So how long, let's say for bankers,
right?
Those who work at the bank, they spend about 7 hours or 8 hours behind the screen. So we advise, when we get to the solutions, I'll give an advice for how we can prevent these symptoms.
Right. Because she's, you know, this lady in particular, maybe she will sit in front of the computer for this whole time that she's at work, and then when you get into your car, you switch to your phone.
Yeah.
And you know, you won't do any messages. But then when you go home, you'd be watching your TV for a couple of hours. So I'm thinking like the whole day is pretty much behind a screen. as well. What are the some of the symptoms that will present themselves when somebody starts, getting or complaining of a computer vision syndrome?
So, because it's a group of ocular conditions, last 2 weeks we talked about dry eyes.
Right.
And I said something about people sitting behind their computer screen and not blinking enough. Mm-hmm. So you get those symptoms as well, the dry eye symptoms, the burning sensation, the tearing, and you are most likely to experience itching as well, back pains, neck pains.
Wow, so it's even going to back and neck.
So because of how you sit, your posture, using the computer, will bring about these neck pains, the eye pains. You feel pains in the eye, like an ocular pain.
Wow.
And your back pain.
I'm tempted to say, so in that state, with the position of you know, how the computer is situated, would that help in any way as well in terms of how you look at it?
Yeah. So when you sit down, when you are behind your PC, your back must touch the chair. So you must get a good lumbar support, so a good back support. Okay. And the screen should be in a position such that you don't lift your head or lower your head too much. So there's an angle where the eye must extend to the screen. So with the image on the screen, you can see the eye is extending at an angle of 20 degrees to the screen, and the screen is tilted in such a way that makes it more comfortable for you. You get
straight.
You sit very well, you get good back support, and your feet should be on the ground. If it's not touching the ground, you can get a support so that you can put your feet on them.
I mean, it's so funny that, you know, this is actually, you know, it really just goes to show how connected everything is when they say the neck bone's connected to the thigh. You know, that song really is something that is very true, because we've talked about this with our physiotherapist in terms of, you know, posture and, you know, and how it, you know, affects your back and all of this kind of stuff. So now for you to even say that your eye can also be negatively affected as well is very... It's amazing how we work.
So the ocular pains come as a result of the demand from the screen to the eye. So once you look at the screen, you look at the screen, then you look at the keyboard, you are switching distances. So the eye also works in such a way that once you switch from distance to near, it adjusts the muscles so that you'll be able to see clearly at near.
So that's basically
When there's prolonged use, so it's like a muscle, you've stretched the muscle for a long time, and you're not allowing the muscle to rest, so you start getting those pains gradually. But I must say that it's not permanent. Once you are experiencing those symptoms, it's just behind the computer screen. But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't find any remedy for it.
Okay.
But sometimes, about 1 out of 10 cases, it becomes like permanent for you.
So when it becomes permanent in that case, you know, are you now stopping work, say, boss, I've got computer vision syndrome, I'm out of here?
Oh no.
You know?
No.
I mean, like, because it's permanent, you're saying it's permanent. So
we give solutions for those things as well. And in our offices, we must know the kind of illumination at the office and how you adjust the monitor, the brightness of the monitor to meet the brightness of the room. When it's too much, the brightness of your computer, the screen, the monitor is too high, and the room illumination is higher than the room illumination, you tend to focus more on the screen than the surroundings. So it puts a strain on the eye. And if the room illumination is too much than the computer, you focus more on the computer screen because you want to see well. Then that also puts strain on the what's best is you try and adjust. You won't be able to get it accurately, but you try and adjust the computer, the illumination on the computer screen to that of the room illumination.
Right, right. Because I've been told, especially, you know, if you're on your phone, especially at night when you're you can't sleep and you then pick up your phone and you're like, let me just see what's going on. Obviously, the room is dark, but and then your phone is really bright in the darkness. So I normally let the light down a little so it comes. So that's the best way to do it, right?
Or there are some phones, they have night mode in them. So you switch to...
That's a new iPhone method.
So you switch to night mode and it works very well. But some parents are at home saying, oh, because I told you that you using the phone at night has caused your eye to... be bad or something, but the thing is how you adjust the light on the phone when using it at night is very essential.
Wow. So are we saying that, you know, if you use the parents in a child's scenario, this is affecting all across board, is adults, children, because now our children are using phones younger and younger. You know, I've seen a four-year-old with his own phone. You know, so yes, he needs to contact his mother. So I guess it's a broad cross.
Yeah, so it's more about the parent teaching the child how to use it and when to use it.
Right.
And the number of time you spend behind it and what you can do when you are sitting behind it for a long time.
Okay.
Maybe, let's say for a corporate man, he gets home and he needs to complete an assignment before the next day. So does that mean, say, oh, I have to finish my work before I get to work because it's very, very important. Does that mean I shouldn't stay behind my computer screen for that long hours?
Yeah.
So we advise that for every 20 minutes, okay, you look at something 20 feet away.
Okay.
So let's say 6 meters.
Right.
Okay, so it's more like a distance object.
Okay.
Look at it for 20 seconds and you come back to it. So it lets the eye relax. It relaxes the eye.
Right.
Or for every 20 minutes, you can just stand and stretch.
Gosh, imagine
for like 30 seconds.
Dr. Bonsu, you are going to make the assignment even long. Imagine, you know, you have to get an assignment in... to work for the morning is 10 o'clock. Mm-hmm. You want me to be getting up every 20 minutes whilst I'm trying to get this assignment done for work in the morning?
Yes. So for every, like, just 30 seconds.
It's a long time. You know how much somebody can type in 30 seconds?
Okay, so there are two choices.
Right.
Is either you want to get the pains associated with it, or you want to be free of it?
That's the only other choice. Older people, please use the 30 seconds and get up.
Yeah, or 20 minutes, after 20 minutes, just look away a distance object at 20 feet, okay, for 20 seconds.
Right.
It's just shorter time.
Getting the, you know, the computer screens, the glares, I mean, they don't do it for mobile. Well, I think some of the mobile cases have the glares and things. Do those help? Would that help in any way?
Yeah, it helps. So for glare, in your workplace or at home, when you're, let's say you're using your personal computer and you are behind the window, the window also casts light from the window casts more light onto the screen.
Right.
So it becomes uncomfortable.
Yeah.
So how you position your screen should will help.
Right.
In those things. So it's more of like an ergonomic, like how you arrange your place to suit your demand.
Yeah. I don't think people even think about, you know, where if there's a window, where to put.
Yeah, they want fresh air. So
exactly. Yeah. Most of the time, it's about fresh air.
They'll put it there.
So is it best to put the screen or whatever it is in front of the window?
No. So it depends on where the light is coming from.
Right.
Let's say the light is coming directly onto the computer screen. That will cause discomfort for you.
Right. And so it shouldn't be shining on the screen.
Yes.
Okay. So it should be, and it shouldn't be behind the screen either.
If it's behind and it's not causing any discomfort, that's why I was saying something about the ergonomics. How it works for you in a room,
Right.
Yes.
Is what you should do. Yeah. Right. Let's talk about treatments and what one can do to try and prevent these kind of stuff from happening to them, and what is out there as well for them in terms of treatment.
One thing that I have to say is looking at a screen. Let's say you go to the airport and the arrival screen is right. There. You see, it's quite high.
Yeah.
So you are tempted to do this way.
Yeah.
It's that because you are not looking at it for a long time. It's not causing a vision syndrome, a computer vision syndrome for you.
Right.
Okay. So it differs from, let's say, reading screens and all. That's different from your personal computer, how you set up your computer to use. So for personal computers, you are most likely, especially laptops, you are likely to put them on our lap
right.
and be looking at them this way. That causes a strain
right.
on the neck.
Yeah.
Okay, and your eyes as well.
Wow.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you try as much as possible to get something to raise it up a bit so that you can use it well.
Yeah.
And sometimes behind the computer, you have a reading material close by where you are looking on it to type.
Right, yeah.
So how well you position it should help you to be able to type well.
Yeah.
So once you bring it down, you put a strain on it because you look down here and you go there. There are two different distances where the eye must change its power to look here and another power to look there. Because you are doing that back and forth for a long time, it brings about strain in the eye as well.
Right.
So for solutions, we first advise that we set up our environment where we work with, especially the personal computers and all. We set the place well. We check the lights, the illumination in the room, and compare that with the brightness of the screen. If the font size on the computer is very small, you can increase it to suit you so that you don't have to strain to look at those small letters.
Right.
People who have astigmatism, we've talked about it. Refractive error. Okay.
Okay. Yes. You are using another word. You didn't use a refractive error. You used astigmatism.
With astigmatism and the hypermyopia.
Yeah.
Those people, you get your corrections on, so that the strain from the eye to the computer becomes less.
Right.
And we advise that for every 20 minutes. You look at something 20 feet away.
This assignment will take forever to finish.
For 20 seconds.
Right. So it's just literally maybe looking, you know, whilst you're typing, blah, 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 20 seconds, maybe you just kind of...
You can... Or maybe you're behind your computer, your colleagues are around, so every 20 minutes, just... Hey, Akusia, yesterday, did you watch?
You know, if I was the supervisor, I'd be like, every 20 minutes you are talking, what is it? Get on with your assignment.
There's some small chit-chat.
No. I won't encourage
you. What are you taking for lunch? okay. Then you get
right.
back.
So it's really about the strain, the distance, basically. It's a strain on the eye looking fast, like something here and, you know, this and that.
Yes,
that's basically what it is.
Yes, because you are changing distances and
right
when you are doing near work, okay, there is more strain on the eye. Energy goes there more
right.
than looking. When you are looking at things are far, the eyes are relaxed.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so right. when I'm so looking at you, my eyes are relaxed
over there, and then
So the distance from you to the screen
right.
should be like an arm's length.
Okay. All right. So
okay.
it should just be the screen should be here.
Yeah.
And then your keyboard can be here. Right.
So some people still complain about this. So per your complaint, we give you the solution. Say, when I'm using the screen for a long time, I get my eyes start burning, it tears and all. So per your what you are saying, we give you a solution for it. So people like that, we give them artificial tears, just like the dry eyes problem. Then we solve it for you. But most of the time, what I've realized is just giving artificial tears for people like that is not effective. very, very effective, even though it's effective. You just have to add a pair of glasses, just plan. Or if there is any correction, you have to correct.
Okay.
Then we give you glasses as well for the screen.
Yeah.
So it has an anti-reflective property, which reflects the light back from getting direct contact to your eye.
I've had a thought. Does the size of the screen matter? Because now we're getting 55 inch screens and 300 inch screens. I mean, is the size a problem? Does being too small or too big have any impact at all?
So once it's big, you get the characters bigger,
right?
Okay, and you can see them well.
Okay.
Once they are small, the characters are smaller. And you have to bring it a little bit closer for you to see.
Yeah.
But it's not a problem if you have a 32-inch or a 24-inch television. You just have to...
What size are you encouraging people to buy?
all sizes, but you see, the light, the most important thing is the light emitting from the screen.
Okay.
So now we are getting... QLEDs, like proper emission of light coming in. They are not very harmful as compared to the olden days, the cathode ray tubes and
So they factored that in. So now they're trying to protect us a little
bit.
So now it's on our side to do the right thing by also not maybe sitting too close. And
So you get a preferred distance, okay? So most likely 6 meters is okay, or 4 meters, 4 to 6 meters is okay. Sit behind and you can watch your telly, but you should consciously blink from time to time. So last week I said the blink rate for per minute is 15 to 20 times. I've observed you today. In a minute you blink like 3 times.
Are you serious? Really? And then I'm really concentrating.
So because you are concentrating on whatever you are doing, your mind switches off from that part. So you have to, sometimes when it comes, you just have to blink.
Wow.
Yeah.
Look at you. I didn't notice that at all.
Now you are now blinking.
Yes, I'm going to be mindful now.
It's very, 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 very important. So to blink, it helps. It brings the tears on the eye.
Yeah.
Then it covers the eye, protects your eyes well. And you see, now corporate bodies, you have, when you get to a place, air conditioning and all, the place is quite cold. That's and evaporation is high. So once you get there, you see, from time to time, you'll be feeling this burning sensation and all. So you have to cultivate the habit of blinking from time to time.
So basically, it's very important to blink. Apparently, I've blinked 3 times. But I will have to check. Roll back, please. Roll back. Let's check. Right. So can it cause any type of blindness or, can it get as severe as that?
Blindness, no.
Okay.
But it can cause a problem in your vision.
Okay.
So how well you see? There are researches being done that indicate that being behind the screen for long hours bring about short-sighted myopia.
Right.
But other researchers have also concluded that being behind the screen for long hours didn't lead to myopia. So research is still ongoing, and we are trying to find ways. That's why people say, Chinese people have small eyes because they can't.
They sit behind the screens for a long time.
But that's not.
Actually, that's a good question. The size of your eye, does it matter?
Oh, no.
You know, if you have googly eyes.
Oh, no.
It doesn't matter at all.
Myopes tend to have bigger eyeball.
Right.
Okay.
Okay. And that helps, or it doesn't help, or it affects more.
It depends on the
It depends
on the demand of vision.
Right.
So let's say if I'm reading and I'm short-sighted, I'm comfortable than you, who is in quotes normal reading and can read for long hours.
Right. Yes. Okay. Well, this has been very informative. Computer vision syndrome it is. Well, if you're just joining us, we've been talking about computer vision syndrome, and Dr. Bonsu, our optometrist, has been taking us through what it is and, you know, how it affects you. I'm going to let him go through it just a little bit more before, you know, we come to, you know, solutions, and then we'll
Wrap it up. I have a question for you.
Oh, no. Oh, don't come and test me, please. No.
It just came to mind. So I want to ask. So when you go to a theater, okay,
mm-hmm.
and they've projected that big screen.
Yeah, like the cinema.
You see, the whole place is dark.
Yeah.
Is it affecting our eyes?
Right, from personal experience, I don't think so because it's quite far. Mm-hmm. I always try and sit on the last 3 or 4 seats.
Oh, okay.
And so because that's true actually, because people don't like to sit in the front because they think that that's too close to the screen.
Yeah.
Doesn't feel, if it's late I fall asleep though. I have fallen asleep at the cinema a few times. But is that okay?
No, that's okay.
Yeah.
And the type of projector they are using to project on the screens mm-hmm. have a low light visibility. Like
right.
the light being reflected back to the eyes yeah. Is low. So
and also I've seen that they have some lights as well. I mean, maybe it's for the stairs because you might just trip
yeah.
and fall to your death. But
I've never been to the cinema. So
have you not?
Tomorrow you take me.
Oh, Dr. Bonsu. Are you asking me on a dating? Right. So I mean, let's just talk about if somebody's just joining us, we're talking about computer vision syndrome, and we're just kind of gone through all of the screens and close up and all. Can you just take us through it one more time, more professionally than I've just gone through it?
Okay. So computer vision syndrome is basically a group of eye conditions that come about as a result of prolonged computer usage or prolonged screen usage behind a computer screen. And I said the causes are refractive errors with the exclusion of myopia, okay, presbyopia as well. Those are basically what bring about it. And symptoms that we get as a result of prolonged sitting behind the computer screen, one is neck pains, back pains, ocular pains, we feel the pains in our eyes, itching, burning sensation, tearing, because of dryness, the dry eyes that we spoke about 2 weeks ago.
Right.
We are most likely to experience these same symptoms because we don't blink enough. And I talked about our posture, how we sit behind the computer screen, and how our back should get a good support, so a good lumbar support, and the screen should be positioned in such a way that we don't have to lift our head
right.
to look at the screen or bring our head down to look at the screen.
Yeah.
So there was an image. Yeah. So the screen, the eye sustains an angle of 20 degrees to the screen, and the screen must be tilted in a certain fashion so that you don't strain more. Yeah. So your feet too must be on the ground when you are using your computer.
Yeah.
And if your feet is not touching the ground, you can get a support where you can put your feet on the ground.
Yeah.
Yeah. So basically that's a correct sitting posture. And because we have people who look on another screen to type on a screen, so a reading material, we advise that it's like closer to the screen or like very close to the screen so that you look at it and you look on there and you can type very well.
Right.
Yes.
And try and look away every 20 seconds
yeah.
during a very important assignment for work.
Yeah. So when you're at work, for every 20 minutes, it's like rule of the thumb. So for every 20 minutes, you look away something at 20 feet.
Yeah.
For 20 seconds.
Right. So just further than the laptop
yes.
or the computer. So
yes.
something maybe just talk to somebody, have a little bit of a break. Is looking at another screen a problem, even though it's at 20? So say you're doing your work on your laptop.
Because
can you look at the TV for 20?
When you look there,
yeah.
you're tempted to get the details.
Right.
Okay. So something, just
so
an object.
It can't be another screen. It, has
it can
to
be another screen.
Right.
But maybe visible, like
okay.
very clear for you.
Right.
Because you are shifting focus from a near point to a distant point.
Yeah.
Even though that will allow you to relax the eye.
Okay.
But once they shift from here to here, you see, it's blur. So it takes quite some time for it to clear.
What is that? You know, sometimes you look at a screen and then you get these little dots. Yes.
So they are after images.
Okay. And
yeah.
And why is after images coming after I've looked?
So yeah, you looked at a bright.
Yeah.
That's why I was talking about the illumination in the room.
Okay.
Should match the illumination on your screen.
Okay.
So once the illumination on your screen is brighter than what's in the room. So we have photopigments in the eye, you have the rhodopsins and the cones. Okay.
Wow.
So once you look on the screen for a long time, the cones are being stimulated more. So once you shift focus from a brighter surface to a less bright surface, the cone starts wearing off for the rods to be produced.
Okay, so,
that you'll be getting these dot dot because it's less brighter. Dot 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 dot. Sometimes when you sneeze, okay, if you see the dot, but they are just temporary. It's nothing.
And, it does clear up. So if you get that often, should you be worried?
When you are getting that often, that means there's something else.
Okay.
It might be floaters in your vision.
Okay,
which is as a result of vitritis or retinal detachment or something, or vitreous detachment.
Right. Okay,
something serious happening behind the eye. If you are seeing strands and some whitish dots in your vision, but sometimes you don't see them, but when you are walking you see them,
yeah,
it's a very serious condition which you must get it checked.
Wow.
Very, very serious.
Very serious.
Yeah, especially if you are below 40 years or let's say 60 years.
Wow.
It's very, very serious. You must get it checked.
Mm. Let's talk about checking again. How often must you check your eyes for the year?
I would ask you, this year, have you checked the eyes?
Please, when you are going, you do it. Because you are here. You might as well.
So,
I think we tend to not regard our eye, you know, eye check. I mean, going into
people come in, they say, say my ninja me, yeah. There was someone who said, you be fine. And the friend who came complaining, like, he's not seeing very well. And the man said, The man said, you be fine, had problems.
What? Oh my God, really?
Problems than
wow.
The one who said, yeah. So sometimes we don't, put more emphasis on our eye health, and it's disheartening and alarming. Yeah.
Yeah, because I mean, in this part of town, you know, there's a lot of dust and all that kind of stuff. So, we should tend to check. So, what do we do? What's an eye? What do you do during an eye check? I mean, really.
Okay.
What do I have to come in? How long is it gonna take?
Routine eye examination. At most 15 minutes, you are done.
Wow, okay.
Yes, at most 15 minutes. If I don't talk plenty, then 15 minutes. But I like talking, so we chat and maybe extend to like 45 minutes.
Hey, doc.
but at most 15 minutes for a routine eye examination, 15 minutes should do.
All right, and we can just go to any...
eye clinic. Yeah.
Do pharmacies do it or no?
No.
Okay.
So you can go to any eye clinic behind closer to you, just to say, and come to check my eyes, and it's just routine.
Right.
You pay for your consultation fee and
I was gonna say, do you have to pay for that? Because for 15 minutes, the gym is car.
So when you come to for viewers listening today.
Right.
From Monday, next week Monday.
Oh, okay.
To Wednesday.
Yeah.
If you visit Godly Favored Eye Clinic.
Yes.
You won't
Which
pay.
Which all the branches?
Yeah, Godly Favored La Paz branch on the same premises with EcoBank.
Okay.
There's a new papaya place there, so you can come in.
Right. And
yeah.
Are you doing free eye checks or what?
So for Monday to Wednesday, for only viewers listening today.
Wow, so they have to come and say HSTV or what?
Yes, that's fine. The code is HSTV.
The code is HSTV, guys. Run. Let's go.
So from Monday to Wednesday,
right.
We do free consultation for you.
Wow.
But if there's something, let's say drops or a further test
or
spectacles that you need,
then you'd have to pay for it. Yes, right. Please. But you'd be doing free eye tests.
My boss will beat me today.
But I think it's good. I mean, you know, everybody so, that's listening.
Yeah, let's.
As we've said, you kind of like tend to ignore the eyes quite a lot because you're just like, I'm seeing fine. There's nothing wrong. I don't need to go and see anybody.
Yeah.
Even myself, I'm very guilty of it. I've had my second dental test this, you know, checkup this year. But not I. Yeah. I haven't even had not one eye check.
So let me go. Year. So Godly Favored Eye Clinic, located on the same premises with EcoBank, Stanchart, and Papaya.
Right.
And we have another branch at Tesano, adjacent Fidelity Bank.
Right. Okay. So you can go to those two branches and get your eye checked. It's free consultation, and Dr. Bonsu will be there. Which one will you be at?
The Tesano branch.
The Tesano branch. So Dr. Bonsu will be at the Tesano branch. You can get your free eye test, free consultation, free eye test. If there's anything else wrong, though, sorry, you would have to pay or, you know, go through everything else. And the code is HSTV. Mm-hmm. So if you've been watching, that is your code. If they don't say it, they have to pay.
Yes, they pay.
Exactly. So please make sure that I hope they've been watching. We're going to repeat it today at 7 p.m. again. Okay. So
I'll watch myself.
Yes, watch yourself. Giving out you know, a free consultation. Yeah. So if for all those watching tonight as well, you can go next week, Monday to Wednesday.
To Wednesday.
Right. Godly favored. Excellent. So, did we talk about solutions?
No.
Let's talk about the solutions.
Okay.
Then.
So, once you're experiencing these symptoms, you have to check your sitting posture.
Mm-hmm.
You have to check how far the screen is from you. You can come to the clinic. We get you some eye drops, some tears supplement, mm-hmm. and we get you anti-reflective glasses to use when, especially behind the computer. But if there's there's a refractive error, you correct the refractive error as well, because those are also they can bring about this computer vision syndrome.
Mm-hmm. Are we? I mean, I always ask about this because I'm just. Is there anything we need to eat that's going to help? That will help, or you know.
Yeah, so foods rich in vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin K.
Right.
They are very essential. And if you have supplements as well, which are rich in vitamin A and D, you can take them as well.
So the thing is vitamin A and vitamin D that are... Yeah,
cod liver oil, salmon oil, those are all good
right.
for the eyes.
Lovely. Right.
So green vegetables, fruits... Must be taking them on a regular basis.
Yes. So, you know, is that old saying true? If you eat carrots, are good for your eyes.
Yeah, carotenoids. So they are good. They are very, very good for your eyes.
Wow. So it's confirmed.
Yes.
By Dr. Bonsu that carrots are good for your eyes. So you must eat
and
carrots.
And Cecilia.
And me too. It's been a great session. Any advice to anybody out there experiencing anything or you know? And what they should do firstly before they can come to you.
Okay, so for computer vision syndrome, you must know that when I sit behind this thing for a long time, I get headaches, I feel this, I feel that. You must know the cause.
Right.
And try and work your way through the cause.
Mm.
Yes. And I've always been saying, if you feel there's something on the eye, if you feel anything, first thing, just wash your face. Make sure your hands are very clean.
Mm.
Check the water coming out is very clean. Wash it. Wash your hands very well. Then wash your face.
Right.
Okay. Then you can come in for a checkup. If you come in and there's something wrong, we tell you. If there's nothing wrong, you are safe. You can go.
Lovely. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming in. As always, continuing with our eyes and. Segments. It's been great and interesting. Very good to know about all the eyes. Right. Hope you've learned a lot from Dr. Bonsu. As he said, if you want to get your eye checked, please go to Godly Favored, right? At La Paz and Tessonor, Monday next week to Wednesday for free consultation. Anything else wrong? You would have to pay though. Right. We're going for a quick break and Cecil will be back in the studio.